Production team studios in the Netherlands. My name is Mixmaster G and welcome to this live stream. My mission is not to sell you as many apps as I can. No, my mission is to educate and teach you about collection management and conversion for DJs so you save yourself more time for the fun and creative part of being a DJ. For those of you unfamiliar with who I am a 54-year-old dude from the Netherlands. I had my first DJ residency at the age of 15. Which means this is almost 40 years of DJ experience in the flesh. I'm no longer an active DJ, I call myself kind of retired. However, I like to share my knowledge with all you guys out there. Wherever I can help, I try to help with all DJ tech related stuff. Some of you might know me about the apps I develop, namely the DJ Conversion Utility, conversion from all big DJ software into each other so you don't have to set cues, loops, etc. Again, over and over again, may you switch gear. But there are much more tools I develop. I do this stream every Tuesday at 7 o'clock. You can always leave your tech-related questions in the chat and I will be happy to address them wherever I can. That's basically the introduction I wanted to give you guys. Let me shout out to some of the people in the chat. Anthony Brown, good evening, Miss Master G. Have you had a good week, sir? Actually, I have. Because, and you will see that later on in this stream, I was very, very, very busy with some new developments in the DJ Conversion Utility. And this stream, I'm going to show you what those new developments are, and they are really game changing. I can already tell you that. So we will head into that later on. Then we've got dialectical spectacle. I'm sure you did that to make sure that some of the people who stream you watch are going to butcher your names. But I see it. Hi, Mixmaster G. Were you a raver back in the 90s? I have to be honest with you, dialectical spectacle, I wasn't. My genre is, I always say the black genre, and I mean that with the highest respect. I am into rap, soul, disco, funk, everything with a groove. And the moment that the hardcore, and we call that raving in the Netherlands, raving was mainly hardcore. And acid house and that kind of stuff broke the scene. That wasn't my cup of tea. That wasn't really my genre. So was I a raver? No, not really. I was a party man, that's for sure, and I'm still am. But raves in the Dutch meaning of the word were not my thing. I understand that especially in the UK, a rave is in general a party. And that's a different thing. But if we were talking about raves in the Netherlands, we were talking about mainly the illegal hardcore fests that were occurring around the country. And that wasn't my cup of tea because that kind, that genre of music is not really my thing. So what I'm going to talk with you guys about today. First of all, I'm going to do a promise I made, namely I was in the DJ TLM stream the other day last week, and there were some questions about, hey TLM, how do you keep track of all your vinyl, because he was doing a vinyl stream and stuff like that. And then it occurred to me that back in the 80s, in the late 80s, begin 90s, I made an app that could do that, and I will show you that. I will show you that very old app, so stand by for that. And after that, we are going to deep dive into Rekordbox 6 yet again. Why is that? First of all, I'm going to give you some tips if you're going from Rekordbox 5 to Rekordbox 6. And I can hear everybody scream and kick, hey Mixmaster G, Rekordbox 6, that has the XML import bug. That costs money because you have to have a subscription. And that's not all true, my friends. First of all, if you just use Rekordbox to create CDJ USBs, then Rekordbox 6 is as free as Rekordbox 5 is, period. If you have a controller that is an unlocked device by Rekordbox 6, it is free for you even to use it in HIT mode. I, with my CDJ 3000s, on the other end, have to pay big bucks if I want to use HIT mode, because the CDJ 3000 is not supported as a HIT device in Rekordbox 6. Different story for different time. So we are going to deep dive how you go from Rekordbox 5 to Rekordbox 6. Some tips to make this a more seamless process, because you can run into some things. Because Mixmaster G himself, yeah, the man who warned you not to go to Rekordbox 6 because of the XML import bug, is going to Rekordbox 6. I've got a Mac Mini M1 working since last Friday, to give you an indication, to convert my 120,000 track library from Rekordbox 5 to Rekordbox 6 and do all the analysis. And that is the reason why we are going to talk about that. Dialectical spectacle, no, the bug is not fixed, but I've got a solution. So that's kind of yes and no. And I will dive into that later on in this stream, because usually if you just start the stream and we are just 8 minutes away, that means that there are not that many people watching yet, so better keep the main dish for the mid of the stream. However, we are going first have a look at that app I spoke about, that app that could catalog, basically for DJs, your vinyl collection. That app was written in, let me find it up, there it is. That app was written in something called Foxbase, multi-user Foxbase, and Foxbase actually. Kevin Bescher, I see you, man. Welcome to the stream, my friend. And multi-user Foxbase was a DBase 3 compatible development environment for the Mac. One of the unique things that Foxbase had was that it could use the user interface elements of the original Macintosh system, something that DBase never could, because that was DOS orientated. It didn't even work in Windows, it was DOS orientated. So that was the environment that I developed a lot of stuff I needed in, and I did as well my collection manager. Having said all that, of course this stuff doesn't work on OS X anymore, so first of all I have to start up my Rekordbox or my macOS. Oh please, get alive. And this is, you are looking here at a virtual environment that is emulating an old Macintosh computer, a 68K Macintosh computer. And that is up and running now. This is it. This is how a Mac used to look like. You see that in the window. Then I fire up Foxbase, which is, as I said, the environment I programmed it in. And then let me find where it's at. It should be right here. This should be the one. Let's see. Yeah, there we are. Now, mind you, this was written in 1988 and the last revision was 1996. And I made this to basically catalog all my vinyl and CDs. So that if I was playing in my studio and I, for instance, when I made year mixes, etc., then you just want to have some things that not automatically come to mind the first thing. So I made this program, and what you can do is, for instance, I can say, all right, I want to have a track that is, why not, 105 BPMs. And then it says, all right, we got the track Bruce and Bongo. It's 105.2 BPM. And now comes the trick. At the right side, you see what is possibly a good match for that track. And you can see that there are all kinds of things. The pitch control is set there. The medium number is set there. And those medium numbers still work. I can still, if I go to 407A1, that is, let me pull that out for you guys. Let's see if I can quickly find that 407. Let's see, there it is. Then indeed, I got the track you see right there, 407. And A1 means first track on the A side. Then you see this yellow thing, more, which means there are more combinations possible with this master track. Namely, if I click this track here, you can see that change, You Are My Melody, is a possible match for it as well. And now it becomes red, which means there are no more matches there. Another thing that you could do is you could switch the master and the mix. So if I click on switch, then that track becomes the master, and then the mix become, so that gives you an opportunity to very quickly dive deep into a vinyl collection, especially if you don't remember all the tracks. Of course, at the regular gigs, you knew what you wanted to spin, so that was something that you didn't need to do. Anthony Brown, would you consider updating and adding to your new tools? No, my friend. This is way too old to update anyhow. Everybody who wants to use this can get it for free, but there is no support for it, because this is really something of the past. But because this question popped up with DJ TLM, and TLM is a friend of the ATDR production team, I thought, why not just show what I made back in the early 90s and 80s, and how that works. And maybe if there is enough, there are enough people who need this, then I can make that, and I can make it much more modern with, let's say, a tap for the BPMs. Back in those days, I used an old Yamaha drum computer that I synced with my SL1200s, with the vinyl or with CD. And then I knew the BPM, because I really hated to count it, and there were not very good tap programs out there that you could tap them out and that they gave you a proper reading of the BPM. I tried to write a few myself, but the computers in those days were simply too old to give you a reliable reading, because pressing the keys had too much latency for that to make it useful. So that's the reason why I used my RI30 as kind of an as a base. I just used it as a base and then made sure that I could sync with that thing by ear. So that's where my mixing skills also developed from. So anyhow, that is Master Mix, the program. And you can see it was already called And the Groove Remains production team back in those days. So this is really, really, really old stuff, but it is remarkable how good it still works. You can even say, all right, I only want the CDs, or I only want the vinyl, so you can make a selection out of that there. You can let it make an educated guess. Do you want to have that guess, or do you want to have this guess, which is... So you can let it make educated guesses, and then once you think, all right, that's a good guess, then you could do it and make an entry out of it. Tito Morales, greetings as well. Thank you, my friend. I try to keep it up as good as I can. Brett Vesely, when you get some time, can you give a quick rundown how to backup music and Rekordbox database? I use Rekordbox 6.5 and Apple Music, new laptop, so I need to put it all on a external for transfer. Brett, I did... I did a special about how you move a Rekordbox database. I think 3 Ask Me Anythings ago. So if you have a look at it, then it will show you. But stick with it, because I'm going to show you some other tricks. But this is not the answer you are looking for. What you need to do is either use the move database function of Rekordbox itself, which is a little bit shaky. Or if you go to a brand new computer, use Apple's migration assistant and make sure that you have a backup of your current MacBook. That is by far the easiest and simplest way to do it. And then I made a tool called the Collection Backup Tool, which will also do it. So there are plenty of possibilities to do it. I did them a few AMAs back. However, if you've got a very, very, very specific question, then I'm happy to address it. The most important thing, if you are going to move your collections between computers, basically, is that the file path to your audio files remains the same. That is always the most important thing, especially for Rekordbox, because if that file path changes, then odds are that you lose your cues and loops. Though Rekordbox 6 has a pretty powerful way to relocate tracks. Talking about Rekordbox 6 and Rekordbox 5. Yeah, Kevin, indeed, importing the collection and linking it up with Discogs would be something that would be possible. However, this tool is so old, I'm not going to maintain it, because this is... Yeah, I know you're a little bit of a technical person too. This is a DBase 3 kind of programming language, which means that is way back in the day. But it still works, it still does the job, so that's the nice part about it. All right, my friends, Rekordbox 5 to Rekordbox 6. Let's go for it, because this can be really a drag. Let me create very quickly, or see if I got something with the Rekordbox 6 collection here. And at the ATDR production team, we always do it. Demo collection, that should be something. But that is April. Let's see if it is Rekordbox 6 or Rekordbox 5. I don't know what the demo collection will be, but we will find out in a moment. And then we go to the applications and to Rekordbox 5. And let's see what we got. There we are. Let's see if there is a collection there. And if not, then we create one collection. I don't see anything happening. Oh, there we go. Nope. No collection there. Close it up. Which means we have to create a collection. And that we can do very quickly, because we create a playlist here and just dump some tracks in it. Like that. And then we create a second playlist, test 2, and dump some tracks in it as well. Then I will very quickly, it is already analyzing, that's nice. So I just have a very simple Rekordbox 5 collection. Now here comes the thing, if you go to Rekordbox 6, you are faced with several options. One of the options is that, let's quit this, is how do you get your stuff in Rekordbox 5? Now I'm going to do this in slow motion, because what I'm going to show now is important, because that gives you an idea how Rekordbox 6, where Rekordbox 6 stores some, not all, some of its most important databases, and how you can make Rekordbox 6 work with the converted data. Because if I'm fire up Rekordbox right now, it will say, all right, I've got an empty collection because there is already something there, and that's not what I want, because I wanted to move. I wanted to go from my Rekordbox 5 collection to my Rekordbox 6 collection. If you go to the Go menu and you press the Alt, the Option key on your keyboard, then all of a sudden you get library here. You see that? If I press the Alt key, it is there. If I let it go, it is gone. That will take you to the user level library folder. That is the library folder that is usually hidden on your computer. And in that user level library folder, DJ Final Touch, salute, good evening, my friend. You will find a folder named Pioneer. Within that folder Pioneer, and let me just make sure that I double click everything so you see what I'm doing, is a folder named Rekordbox, and in that folder named Rekordbox is a master DB. You see that? Master database. Master database, that is your Rekordbox 6, not your Rekordbox 5, your Rekordbox 6 database. And let me show you what happens the moment you rename that database, Master 1 database. If I start up Rekordbox 6 now, Rekordbox 6 will say, hey, I don't have a database, what the fuck do you want to do? And that is exactly what I want to, because then I can convert my Rekordbox 5 data. You see, now it comes up with that convert thingy. However, before you start converting, it is best to make sure that your preferences are set correctly. And that means I'm going to an empty library because I cannot go to the preferences with that thingy on. Or maybe I can, by the way. Oh, I can. Hold on, let me do that again for you folks, because I want to give you all the proper information, right? So let's rename this. You see there's a new master DB created. I just delete that one. I fire up Rekordbox 6 again. Let's see if it can take us to the My page as well. Let's see if it will do that. No, it won't. It will not take me to the My page. However, I can go to the Preferences. That's an important one, because then I can go to Analysis. I disable the Auto Analysis, and I disable all the other analysis. This is important. Now, everybody knows that dreadful thing that lyrics are searched and the dread thingy comes down the Rekordbox window telling you that it cannot find lyrics and stuff like that. There is a way to disable that, but it's not simple. So to disable that, we have to go to the actual to the performance mode, and I cannot switch that yet. So let me make that empty library just now, because the preferences are not stored in the collection, so I can just create an empty library and then later on go to the empty again. So make it empty again. So we just have to wait for a little bit for Rekordbox. I don't know why it's taking that so long. Come on, man, you can do it. Ah, it is doing something, but I don't know what it is doing actually, because now it's hidden. Maybe I did quit it. Might be possible. Let's see. The mysterious ways of Rekordbox. And now it will not fire up again. I think I broke something. But that happens to me all the time, so, and I know where to find it if I break stuff, but this is not good, friends. This is not good at all. So let me force quit Rekordbox again there. Let me go back to my library again. And let me just see what happened there. Let me take that one out. Let me turn that one on. And then let's see what will happen, if anything. Because maybe nothing will happen, you never know. That's better. So that's how you can fix stuff like, hey, my Rekordbox is not working anymore. You just saw it live, how you can do that. All right, Back to what I want to show you guys. First of all, make sure that your analysis, and you can see they are off now, and that is the analysis tab right there where you do that. But now about that lyrics thing, and that lyrics thing really was driving me nuts. What you need to do is you have to switch to performance mode. Then you go to the preferences. I didn't find this out myself. This is Pioneer's ID. Go to lyrics. All of a sudden you have a lyrics there. You see that? You can click it. And there you can, usually it is enabled, so disable it. And usually this one is enabled. Acquire lyrics when analyzing tracks. You want to disable that. That is that little thingy that makes everything red when you are analyzing tracks. In short, now I've got my settings. Further on, I am on the good username. That is just a test user. Once you have set this all, disconnect from the internet. Quit Rekordbox, disconnect from the internet. Why is that? Because if you are on the creative plan and you have the cloud sync enabled, that means that everything is going to be synced to the cloud as well at once. You don't want to do that during the conversion stage. You want to do that once everything is converted. So if you are ready to convert from Rekordbox 5 to Rekordbox 6, disconnect from the internet. Make sure that your Wi-Fi is turned off, like there, that you pull out the UTP-45 cable, and then let's say we take that one away and we fire up Rekordbox, and it will tell us or ask us what we want to do. And this will be, of course, very quickly because it is just a few tracks which we just dumped in it. We say convert right there. And because I set the preferences all correct, this should be really quick. However, if that same problem that I had earlier appears again, no, we are good. So there you can see everything has been done. There we've got the two playlists. There is a chance that if you have done this, there is a dialog box telling you that some of the analysis was done with an old version of Rekordbox. If that is the case, then the function add new analysis data right there will become available. So this is the case, and most likely if I quit Rekordbox now and if I start it up again, we will have that dialog. Some reason it will not pop up directly after the import, but it will pop up the next time we start Rekordbox. And that's the reason why I'm diving into this stuff with you guys, just because I was facing with all these issues myself over the weekend. And I thought, all right, I really have to tell people how to do this stuff, because this is nuts. And if you don't know what's happening, then you really get lost. Let's see if we got that message. We still don't get that message. That's weird. Let's go back to export mode. That's my favorite mode anyway. There we are. Select all the tracks, and then you can say add new analysis data. That means that all tracks will be analyzed for just the waveform, just for the graphical representation on the screen. Of course, you can do a regular analysis. However, then you have to make a choice. Do you want to analyze for grid, for key or phrase? If you just do OK, there will not be an analysis. You see there? If you don't select one of the three, there is no analysis. Alternatively, you can say, I want to analyze for phrase, because that information is not converted from anything. So that makes sense. But you want to have the key and the grid from your previous version. So you never want to enable those. You want to enable them for maybe new tracks that you add only to Rekordbox. But if you convert from a previous version, you don't want to enable it. The safest thing to do is just say right here, add new analysis data, click it. Then you see right in my lower left corner that it is analyzing, and then that thing should disappear. Let's see. Yeah, you see now it disappears. That means all the waveforms are capable to show the bloppy three color wave things, if you like that. I just like the monochrome blue things, but that's more legacy than anything else, because I like how this looks. This looks very familiar to me and something I can work with. So that are just some pointers that are important if you are going to convert from a Rekordbox 5 to a Rekordbox 6 collection. So let me recap that. First, make sure that your preferences are correct. That means turn off the lyric acquisition during analysis. Make sure that there is no analysis done automatically anyway, because you don't want to do that, because you want to keep your grid and your keys from the previous older version. And if you have set that all correctly, make sure that you quit Rekordbox and quit every Rekordbox that might be running on your computer. And quitting Rekordbox means that the little dot underneath Rekordbox is gone. Only if it's gone, Rekordbox is closed, is quitted. And from that point on, you can disable, or you can rename, or you can erase the master database in the Pioneer folder, in the hidden user library folder. I know it's a mouthful sorry folks. This one, the master database, and then you can say convert, and you will see that it will convert fairly quick. The actual conversion of my 120,000 tracks collection from Rekordbox 5 to 6 took something like 11 hours, which is fairly quick. The analysis after it for the waveforms can take ages. Another thing that is worth to notice is you can quit when it's analyzing, you can quit Rekordbox. And if you do that, then all the previous analysis is saved. So for instance, I am doing 120,000 tracks analysis. I just selected them all and said add new analysis data, as I just showed you in Rekordbox. However, every 20,000 tracks, I will quit Rekordbox. I will quit it. I might be even able to show you guys the process. Give me just a moment. I will walk to my M1 computer that is doing all the work right now and see if I can TeamViewer into it. If I can TeamViewer into that computer, I can show you guys another trick, which is really, really, really helpful if you want to have the maximum speed when you're converting this, and the most safest, because there is nothing worse if you are doing a 120,000 track analysis and a Rekordbox all of a sudden 60,000 tracks in says crash and everything is gone and was for nothing, was down the drain. So you have to prevent that kind of stuff. In order to prevent it, you can do that. So let me see if I can TeamViewer into my Mac Mini. And then I can show you live how I approach that kind of stuff. There we are. Let's see, TeamViewer is there. That Mac is really, really, really busy. Oh, hold on, it doesn't have internet. No, I cannot show it, my friends, because remember what I told you, you have to disconnect from the network in order to make sure that that you are running maximum speed and not everything is synced to the cloud every now and then, but that you first do all the analysis and all the imports and then you sync it all to the cloud together. That is exactly what my Mac Mini is doing right now. So I cannot TeamViewer into it because it's not connected to the network. It's just standalone doing its thing. But what I wanted to show you guys is this. Let me go back to my screen there. If you see Rekordbox doing its analysis and it's counting down in the lower left corner, you can see the counter normally running there. You can right then quit Rekordbox. Just say command Q. Usually you get the beach ball. Don't be afraid. It might take 5 to 10 minutes to quit, to close all the files. And that is why it's so important to do it every now and then. Only if the dot under Rekordbox is disappeared, you are safe. What I personally do is I run a carbon copy clone backup of the entire startup drive of that computer just to make sure that everything is also backed up. Then I go back, then I reboot the computer because that refreshes the memory and everything, which means everything is back to maximum speed. And I fire up Rekordbox again, I select all those tracks, I say add new analysis data, and it will pick up where it left off. That's the beauty of it. So that is the thing I wanted to tell you. You can quit it, you can backup, you can reboot, and then you can just select everything and say add analysis data, and it will automatically skip what it has already done, and it will pick up from the point where the new stuff begins. So that is really awesome. Now we are going for the real new stuff, the DJ Conversion Utility and the things that I changed about it. Let's see if I can find my mouse, because right now, there it is. Let me connect my server disk. There we are. The terabyte is connected. The most dreadful thing right now using the DJ Conversion Utility is that you have to import XML data into Rekordbox. Basically, the whole conversion process is a two-stage process. One is the pure conversion done by the DJ Conversion Utility, and that will create a Rekordbox XML. And after that, you have to import the information from that Rekordbox XML into Rekordbox. And that's a manual process. You have to invoke it yourself. There are a few things with that. First of all, it is slow. It is very, very slow. With my own real life collection, it could take like 4 hours to import just 50 new tracks, which is weird. Another thing is we have the XML import bug, and that means that I was basically advocating stay on Rekordbox 5.6.0, because that was the last version that didn't have the XML import bug. But there are some other things as well, because in Rekordbox, memory bank entries, loops and queues in the memory bank, can have a color. You cannot have that property set into an XML. So basically, you didn't have colors for the memory queues, for the hot queues you had and for the hot loops, but not for the memory queues and loops. That is possible now. And it is also possible to make a memory loop an active loop, and I will dive into that a little bit later. First of all, let me show you guys just what this is all about. This is all about a new app that is included in the beta of the DJ Conversion Utility. And not much changed at face value, because let's go from Serato. And mind you, there is no warning anymore. There is no warning that the Rekordbox XML bug is there. However, there is a new button. You can see it right here. Invoke XML to Rekordbox 6 after conversion. You can disable it, and there is your warning. But if you leave it enabled, that means that the DJ Conversion Utility will still do its thing that it always does, and then it will start a new app. Oh, sorry, Kevin, my bad. Let's do that again. Let me start that over again. Yeah, Daddy Doe, I saw it. Good that you shouted out, boys, because this is my you all know the drill. Normally, I'm so taken in my stories that I forget to switch the camera views. So here we go again. The new DJ Conversion Utility looks like the old one. Is basically for the better part the old one, because this is all familiar. You can see there is only no warning. However, there is this new checkbox, invoke XML to Rekordbox 6 after conversion. If I switch that off, there you have your warning again. If you switch this on, what will happen in the back is the DJ Conversion Utility has installed a new app. And that new app is named X to Rekordbox 6. Remember, a year ago we had 6 to X, now we've got X to 6. Yeah, I don't make these names up, they just come to me naturally. And you see this new app, XML to Rekordbox 6. If you run the new beta of the DJ Conversion Utility for the very first time, make sure that you give this little bugger all the required privileges in the security and privacy settings. You can even run it, you can even start it up, and that will take you to the setup process, or you can let the DJ Conversion Utility start it up, and that is basically what the invoke means, that it will start up that particular app. The fun is there is no user interface or nothing. However, setting it up is a bit of a challenge. If you are familiar with the DJ Conversion Utility streaming, it's the same setup procedure. With the beta comes some readmes. Read them, they will take you through it. But please don't overthink the process. Stick to the process. The process is made for it to be successful on both an M1 Mac and an Intel Mac. Now I hear you think, hey Mixmaster G, but how can I obtain that beta of the DJ Conversion Utility streaming? Right here we've got the famous message box. A lot of people forget about it, but it is right there. If you click it, you will see today that new public beta of the DJ Conversion Utility streaming. The download link is right below it. If you right click it and say open URL, it will open it and you get it. Same things as always, apply to it, make sure that you give it all the required settings. Now let me show you what this will do. And this is boring and very great at the same time. So we go from Serato, we leave the invoke XML to Rekordbox on. We make a selection of something. You already saw the Rekordbox 6 collection, nothing particular there of interest. However, we are going to change that right here because let's take that one, that folder. And for now, it's just sit back and enjoy the show. There is no Rekordbox XML import anymore. There is nothing else. The Rekordbox XML is still produced because that will be used as the base in X to Rekordbox 6. Actually, XML to Rekordbox 6 is invoked. This is the beta warning you will always get because it is beta software. So this is where the beta really starts. Click I understand. If it is the first time, then it will ask you to take you through the setup steps, which are pretty much straightforward. And after that, it is all hands up and it will open Rekordbox 6 automatically. And if you have the analysis in Rekordbox 6 enabled and have it set to phrase analysis, then it will automatically analyze the tracks, which means you set it on, you go to bed, you wake up and everything is converted. There we are. Don't need to see the log. And right now you see a new playlist, XML to 6, X to 6. And that will tell you which tracks were added to the Rekordbox 6 collection, which were not already there. And of course we have the selected Serato crates, and that's basically what we selected in the DJ Conversion Utility. And you can just open it and do with it whatever you want. You can load it up, for instance. Now, mind you, the beat grid, everything is there. The only thing that is not there is the overview, and that will be set the moment it is analyzed. Let me make the comment section a little bit smaller for that. But you see, the cues are there. Now, mind you, this is the memory bank. They got the same purple cues. The hot cues are there. Everything is there. No XML import anymore. All on automatic. I think this is really, really great stuff. This works for all the DJ Conversion Utility conversions to Rekordbox XML. It can even work with Rekordbox XML exported from Rekordbox. So the guy who asked about, hey, how can I get my data from one computer to another? If you have the Rekordbox XML, then you can even use X26 to import that all and put it inside a Rekordbox collection. Now there are some really cool other tricks that I can do with it, and I'm really proud of it. I don't know if I have a valid Rekordbox or a tractor collection here, so hold on just a moment. Let's see what I got. Local tracks, there is something there. Let's see if it, yeah, that loads up. That's nice. All right. I don't know the track, so let's just put a loop at the end of it and just a random loop. This is most likely not going to make much sense, but what it will do all together more. Let's name this one catch loop. You can also name it CA, you can also name it active loop. What that will mean, you will see in a moment. Let me just finish this and just convert the whole stuff. Normal DJ Conversion Utility work here. And fire up the DJ Conversion Utility. Tell it that we are coming from Traktor. And again, you can see the invoke XML is already enabled. If you don't see it being enabled or you cannot select it, that means there is no valid Rekordbox 6 collection on your computer, or at least the drive that they are the master database on is not mounted. So then it's not available. There are all kinds of safeguards built into this. So that you all know. I had the local tracks, I think. And then just sit back. This is the conversion, the DJ conversion utility. XML is created. And then XML to Rekordbox 6 is fired up. Of course, when I'm confident that most of the major bugs are dead, then that message will disappear. But for now, that message is there just to tell you that you are working with beta software. By the way, it makes backups of the master database. So even if things go entirely wrong, you can still recover from it. I haven't had that situation yet. And trust me, I have thoroughly tested this before I left it out to you guys. But hey, you never know what is going to happen. But you can see the power of this. And let's see where we are right now. Let me close this all up. And there we've got the selected Traktor playlist. Again, XML to Rekordbox. This playlist is created, and then you can see that there were tracks added and there were tracks updated. So there is diversion there. And then if you go to the selected to the local tracks, and then something like Azimuth, or I don't know what, I think this was the one. Let me load it up. There it is. Now, look at that catch loop. All of a sudden, it became an active loop. For you guys who don't know what an active loop is the most powerful feature of Rekordbox, and it also works on CDJs. The moment your playback head enters that active loop, it will arm and it will start to loop. Now there is one big but, because active loop is not always enabled automatically. In Rekordbox, you have to make sure that it is enabled, and you can see that right here, active loop on. So let me do that slowly. This is what my friend Jeroen Groenendijk calls the hamburger menu. If you click it, you can go to active loop, and there you can set it to on. And the moment you do that, and let me go a little bit fast forward, then it is playing back, it's playing back, and then it hits the active loop and bam, it becomes active. That loop is coming from Traktor, my friends. And because I named it active loop or catch loop, it has been converted to a catch loop that is active. And I think that is really powerful stuff. You cannot do this in the export mode with a hot cue. It is possible to do it in the performance mode, but I think that is a bug from our friends at Rekordbox. So this is something new in the DJ Conversion Utility, and it sounds very straightforward, very silly. Hey, you can take it, you can skip the XML import, it will be all there. But trust me, this was a shitload of work. One of the things that it also does, besides it's convenient and gives you more options, it is much faster. I did some test runs on my big collection on the M1 computer, and this procedure, so basically importing stuff from a Rekordbox XML into a Rekordbox 6 collection using X26 with 4,900 track collection in XML to my 120,000 track collection usually. That XML import, if I were to do that through Rekordbox, would take approximately 72 hours. That's 3 days. Using the tool, it took me 90 minutes. So you can see there is a huge speed bump there to get the converted stuff into Rekordbox 6 by using it, and no longer we have the XML import box. So winning all around. I highly recommend you to play with it a little bit, to have a look at it. If you experience problems with it, please contact me. Like I said, the setup can be a little bit tricky. I'm fully aware of that, but there is not much I can do about it. I just made it as user-friendly as I can. But hey, it is what it is. So sometimes things, we are all trying to do stuff that none of the software I'm doing the stuff for is made for. So sometimes you have to go a little bit hacky to get it all in. And that's the reason why this stuff can be a little bit complicated. Those were the things that I had prepared for you guys to share with you guys during this Ask Me Anything. Of course, I'm totally open for each and every question that you guys might have regarding collection management and conversion for DJs. So if you've got a question, please drop it in the chat and I'm happy to address it. Otherwise, I'm going to wrap up in a moment. I'm first going to grab myself some water because I'm really getting a sour throat now. And otherwise, if there are no more questions, then I hope to see you guys next week. No idea what I will do as a subject next week, because each week it comes as it comes. I didn't expect X26 to be revealed this quick, because basically the framework was done by the end of last week and I had to test it all internally, but integrating it in DJ Conversion Utility was a lot easier than I thought occasionally. So that's why it's already there out there. If I don't see any questions popping up anymore, that means that I'm going to wrap up. There's something here. Anthony Brown, you are more than welcome, my friend. I'm happy to do this stuff. And to be honest, I'm going to benefit from it myself as well, because I wanted to go to Rekordbox 6, but because of the XML import bug, I stayed on 5.6.0, and now I can safely go to Rekordbox 6. And see what that can offer, because you have to keep up with Joneses. So that's why I'm really, really happy that I was able to get this actually working. For all of you on the other platforms, I will disconnect them in a moment. For all of you on Twitch, we are going to raid into somebody else. I don't know who we are going to raid into. So let me have a look who are on. Never have an ID. No, I don't want to leave that. All right, this is going to get more and more complex by each and every day, which means I will just raid with the people on Twitch into whoever is on. People on Facebook, people on YouTube, thank you for sticking with me. If you like what I'm doing, then please don't forget to give this video the thumbs up and spread the word about these Ask Me Anything sessions with all your DJ friends, because I'm just here to help whoever I can help, and I'm always happy to help out. So just ask me and I will see what I can do about it. I will be here next Tuesday, 7 o'clock Central European time. Now let's move to Twitch and let's see who are actually on Twitch at this moment in time. And that's always a little bit of a gamble, right? My friend Scratch Blast is on, but he doesn't really need our support because he is... I see DJ Strobe is on. I hope DJ Strobe is on a little bit longer for that. So let's raid into DJ Strobe. If you don't know DJ Strobe, DJ Strobe really, really has some very nice videos going on in his own channel. I'm not sure what he's doing, but he has a cap video and he has got all kind of crazy stuff. So that's always nice. Are there now questions popping in? Always great, quick question after conversion. All right, we are getting questions. Yeah, thank you, Kevin. That update really, really, really is something, and it really is great. Let's see what I've got a question from Lots More. Lots More, always great. Quick question. After my conversion and update of my main library, what is the best workflow for updating playlists in a long software? I'm not entirely sure what you mean, Lots More, because if you do your conversion, then you select usually playlists unless you use the modification date selection criterion, and that means that those modified playlists will be imported. And if you tuned in a little bit later, I just showed the new beta of the DJ Conversion Utility, which is out there as a public beta. So if you are a licensed user of the DJ Conversion Utility, you can use that beta, and that means you no longer have to import, do the XML import. That will be all taken care of. So if it's conversion to Rekordbox 6 you are talking about, then it will be automatic. In general, I always advocate using iTunes or the music app with the proper settings as your base collection manager. So base collection manager in my book means you make playlists in it, you make the common text, the artist, the title, the artwork, the album, the release year, stuff like that, basic stuff. Do that all in iTunes, because then that will always be available to all the other software you use, not only for now, but also in the future. And that is why I'm always advocate use iTunes or music as your basic collection manager. Take one particular DJ software, the one you like, as your base DJ software to set your cues and your loops. And from there on out, from that pair on out, convert to everything else, because that will make you so flexible, because those iTunes playlists will pop up everywhere. And the DJ Conversion Utility makes sure that you can use cues and loops, grids you have once created in all other DJ software. So that really makes it very easy. Kevin, yeah, thanks. That update is, I'm really, really, really proud of it. It is a very, very nice accomplishment, and I'm very proud of it, especially that I can do stuff like setting beat grids, etc. All right, friends. Not sure if there are more questions popping in or popping up. If not, then we are still going to rate DJ Strobe. So let me do that. Let me just rate into DJ Strobe, and that means that I always forget that that's /rate. And then DJ Strobe, and let's see if that is accepted. Yeah, that is accepted, and we are going to rate into DJ Strobe. Everybody else on all the other platforms, thank you for watching. For now, Mixmaster G is going to sign off.